Hello, my name is Alex Coe. I'm with MilliporeSigma, the life science business of Merck KGaA, Darmstadt, Germany. I am a field application scientist located in San Diego, California, the United States. Today's video will focus on Multiplex magnetic bead assays, which are based on Luminex's XMAP technology. Briefly, color-coded microspheres, distinguishable spectrally using an instrument such as the Magpix behind me, are coated with different antibodies and mixed together in the same plate well to enable accurate and specific measurement of many different protein markers in the same sample at the same time. This is known as multiplexing. At certain points in a typical Multiplex assay workflow, it is important to wash the bead suspensions in the sample wells to minimize non-specific reagent binding. In the case of magnetic bead assays, this can be effectively and efficiently achieved using a handheld magnetic separator, such as shown here. In this video, I'll describe this device in more detail. I'll go over the other supplies and reagents you'll need to perform a plate wash, and I'll end the video with a demonstration of the wash protocol. Please stay tuned.
Here is a top view of the plate separator. There is an array of magnetic pins arranged throughout the surface of the device where the plate would sit. They enable washing by attracting beads from suspension to the mylar well bottom, holding them in place while liquid is decanted from the wells. Two metal latches enable secure plate fit, while an orientation guide ensures correct plate positioning. This device is pre-optimized to fit Multiplex assay plates and does not require further adjustments. Other materials you need to perform a Multiplex plate wash include a P200 or 300 pipette and matching tips, a clean reagent reservoir, a timer, an orbital shaker able to reach 800 RPM, clean paper towels, a clean bottle, and the 10x wash buffer included in the Multiplex kit. This 10x stock should be diluted 1 to 10 with deionized water ahead of time. 300 milliliters of 1x buffer should be sufficient for all washes associated with an assay. Of course, please remember to wear safety glasses, gloves, and lab coat when working with Multiplex assays. To prepare the assay plate for wash, carefully remove it from the orbital shaker after its previous incubation is complete. Secure it onto the separator, ensuring that the plate is flat, both latches are locked, and that the lip of the plate sits below the latches. Incubate on the bench for at least 60 seconds to ensure that the beads are firmly held by the magnetic pins. Next, carefully remove the adhesive seal and pick up the separator by its base, with the assay plate still locked in. Invert it over an appropriate waste container and use strong downward force to eject liquid well contents while leaving the beads undisturbed. Briefly dab the assembly on a clean paper towel. To begin the wash cycle, remove the plate from the separator by unlocking the latches and dispense 1x wash buffer from a clean reagent reservoir into the assay wells, using fresh tips each time. Shake the plate at 300 RPM for 30 seconds to circulate the beads with the buffer. Ensure that no spillover occurs between wells. Secure the plate back on the separator, again incubating for 60 seconds to ensure that the beads are fully retained. Subsequent decanting of wash buffer will complete one wash sequence. This cycle should be repeated as many times as directed by the kit protocol before proceeding to the next assay step. Thank you for watching this video.